Racing to the 2025 Kentucky Derby, and this time around, we're going to take a look at some of the recent winners at the Keeneland meet. We're going to take a look at some colts, some fillies. We're going to look at some dirt races and some turf races. Remember, at this time of the year, more horses will run themselves off the Derby trail than will run themselves on it. But you do need to have a look at some of these horses as they start to fill out some of the allowance non-winners of two. Some of these maidens come back into stakes races and some horses to follow this fall and early into 2025. Of course, we're in the Kentucky Derby prep season. We've already got a leaderboard update up. If you want to watch that video right here on the channel, hit like and subscribe. But today we're going to take a look at some of the top recent Keeneland winners. Led by an allowance race, we've got Authentic Strike. Of course, Authentic won the Kentucky Derby for trainer Bob Baffert. What was interesting about this race, he kind of bolted on the turn. The jockey has to steer him in, and Authentic Strike wins that allowance race. Non-winners of two at Keeneland, a Brisnet speed figure of 87 on the race for the son of Authentic. Now let's go to Keeneland. We've got Built. Built is by Hardspun, the sire, a Brisnet speed figure of 89. And what I like about this, improved in a second lifetime start, kind of a presser running style, won at the all-important distance of 7 furlongs. A lot of times those 7 furlong winners, they can stretch out to those a mile to a mile and a 16th type races. Built didn't run particularly fast here, but what I like is it showed improvement and kind of a low running style down that lane for Built in breaking his maiden at Keeneland. Another recent winner at Keeneland was Uncle Jim. This one trained by Brad Cox. The sire is City of Light. The broodmare sire is Tisnow. So a little bit more stamina in this pedigree. Of course, City Light in his one of his first couple of crops, he did have Fierceness on the trail in 2024. The Brisnet speed figure was 81. But again, at this time of the year, you know, as long as you're really over a 75 Brisnet speed figure, that's good enough, because what you're looking for, horses will improve 2 to 3 speed figure points a month all the way up until March. So if they're over 80 at this time of the year, that'll get them up to that 100 mark by the time we get to March. A nice win from Uncle Jim. Now, David of Athens, this one surprised 22-1 first time out. The sire is Nyquist, a first-time starter, won at the distance of 6 furlongs, came a little bit off the pace, but you know, Nyquist has had some nice horses on the trail the last couple of years. Some of them haven't necessarily made it to the Kentucky Derby starting gate, but they've had some nice fillies, some nice colts. I still think he's a sire to watch. He gets good mares. They pay good money for these Nyquists. We'll see if David of Athens can progress here as we start to look in the November-December time frame and into 2025. David of Athens, a son of Nyquist, getting a maiden victory at Keeneland. Now, another one that won at Keeneland was Touchy. This one, another Nyquist winner. Wesley Ward, you know, over the years, his horses don't necessarily stretch out and improve. He gets them ready first time out. He gets them ready to win. They're bet down a lot of times. This one won at 6.5 furlongs. Wesley Ward does run a string at Turfway Park. And with those big races at Turfway Park on the synthetic, big purse money, we've seen some of those horses run well on some of the later spring preps. And really, with all that purse money, you can stay there. And we saw a horse like Two Fills go from the synthetic to the dirt and run a big race. It seems like more and more some of these trainers are just staying right in Kentucky and moving along on the trail, stretching them out in distance. And Touchy could be one to watch as we get into the Turfway Park meet in December in Kentucky. Now you've got Poster. This one was a turf race. What I like about it, Eoin Hardy trains out of a tappet mare by Munnings. You know, we do see some horses go from turf to dirt. What I like here, got a little bit of experience, kind of went out in the drive and then picked up the win late in that race. Ended up winning by almost 3, so a nice win on the turf four-poster winning this race at Keeneland. Who knows? We could see him down at Tampa Bay. Eloy and Hardy usually brings a small string to Tampa Bay in the wintertime, and he'll also run a little bit of Gulfstream every now and then. But Poster getting that second lifetime win at Keeneland, mowing the lawn on the turf. Now, another winner to look at is Vola Magic. Sire is Volatile, and the trainer is Steve Asmussen. Winner on debut, bet down a little bit, drew off impressively. What I like about this one, just looks like a good, nice runner. And a lot of times, Steve Asmussen, his horses will improve in that second and third start, as he likes to just kind of start them off, get a win, and then he'll bring them down to the fairgrounds. He also utilizes Oaklawn Park in that winter time. He'll ship them back and forth depending on if he wants the longer stretch of Louisiana or the shorter stretch of the Oaklawn Park. So Vola Magic, first crop sire of Volatile. Of course, Steve Asmussen trained Volatile, of course, who is a good sprinter. We'll see if his horses can stretch out. Now, a filly to note on the trail at Keeneland, could be going down to the fairgrounds. George Arnold trains the Myrtlewood Stakes. Wanted to show you Echo Sound. This was just a big filly. I like the way she closed out down the lane. The trainer is George Arnold. Three starts now, three wins, won the Myrtlewood Stakes, and Echo Sound definitely could be a filly to watch as we get to the fairgrounds this winter, or another one that could stay for a race like the Bourbonnet Stakes, or maybe go to Oaklawn Park for that series. Of course, we saw Torpedo Anna come out of there, the Fantasy Stakes winner, then go to the Kentucky Oaks in 2024. Echo Sound, a nice win in the Myrtlewood Stakes. Don't forget, the Triple Crown Trail starts to heat up, the road to the Kentucky Derby. We've got the Remsen Stakes, the Demoiselle Stakes for fillies. Then you've got the Kentucky Jockey Club at Churchill Downs. That'll be Thanksgiving weekend. Springboard Mile at Remington Park, their big prep. Then you've got the Los Al Futurity on December 14th. Already the nominations are out for the Los Al Futurity as we continue along. Don't forget, free racing picks for selected Saturdays. We've got the Cigar Mile Day and also some Oaklawn Park days coming up this fall. Sign up once and you're good. Of course, we'll do this about 25 times in 2025, racing picks for selected big days, top three racing picks. Also, the Triple Crown Prospectus gearing up for season number 4 comes out Monday, January 6th to kick off the season. And we'll read you through every Monday, 2,000 words on the three-year-old scene, both the colts and the fillies. Rankings, we'll take a look at some pedigrees, also some trip notes, and keep you up to date on that Triple Crown season. Every Monday, 2,000 words, sign up. If you're already signed up for this year, you're good to go for 2025 as we continue along with season number 4. Now remember, who are you most impressed with at Keeneland? What did you think of some of these winners? Who are some horses you're taking an eye on from Keeneland and Churchill Downs? Leave a comment. Remember, share, like, and subscribe as we get you through the juvenile racing season. And remember, Dwayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.